Welcome back to Trailer Trash Flips. Today is going to be a really short video. It's not going to be a pulling orders video or showing you what I bought or anything like that. But I do want to show you how I'm going to make a fairly cheap holder for my rolls of bubble wrap. And by cheap, I mean it's going to be less than $20, but it's going to be very easy to put together. My bubble wrap sits on top of a stack of USPS boxes, which sit on top of this mini fridge. And I don't have much bubble wrap left. This is my last roll, so I do need to order some more pretty soon. But I did want something where every time I pull my bubble wrap, it didn't slide off. These USPS boxes have not always been up here. I just had extras last time I put in an order at the post office, and you can see I'm pretty well stocked up on USPS boxes. And unfortunately, with Ground Advantage, I'm not using all that many of the boxes, so I'm gonna have to find somewhere to put them for the time being, and I'm sure that will include this stack. So the bubble wrap will actually sit directly on top of the mini fridge. So I went to Lowe's and I picked up this wood panel. It's 18 inches in diameter and it's 1 inch thick. Now I got this round one because it was about $14. They also have the pre-cut 24 by 24 pieces, but those were a little bit bigger than I wanted. And plus, by buying this, I don't have to cut any wood. I also went to Dollar Tree and picked up some of this non-slip shelf liner and a pack of super glue. And for the center, I have these shower rod pieces that I bought at the bin store. Luckily, I only paid a dollar for these, and I have two of them here, but I only need one. And if you didn't want to buy a shower rod just to cannibalize it for the bubble wrap holder, you could just as easily get a PVC flange and a piece of PVC pipe, or even a metal flange and some metal pipe, and do the exact same thing. I'm not gonna have much into this project. $14 plus $2.50, so that's $16.50, plus $1 for the shower curtain piece. So I've got under $18 into this project. And I'll also need four screws, which these are some that I pulled out of a bin that I have, where I just put loose screws just to have hopefully the proper size whenever I need some screws or nuts or bolts. And luckily I did have four of them that will work just fine for this project. Okay, this is gonna be the bottom. So I'm gonna trim out some of my non-slip shelf liner to fit pretty much the entirety of the bottom piece of the wood. Because when I'm going to pull the bubble wrap, I really don't want this sliding. Okay, I got part of it laid out. So I'll cut off some extra. And I'll cut off some more excess that's going to be on the other side of the wood. All right, got everything lined up pretty well. Next, I'll take a Sharpie and I'll just trace along here so that I'll have a good line to trim everything out with. All right, let me lift that up. And next I'll take my scissors, just trim this out, and I'm gonna trim a little bit on the inside of this line since the mark that I made was kind of on the outside of the edge of the wood. Okay, it's all trimmed out. Now I will lay my wood down just to make sure it's gonna fit okay. It's a little bit wrinkled right there from where it was on the roll, so I'll switch it around so that maybe that'll lay a little flatter. And it looks pretty good. I think I need to do a little tiny bit more trimming right here and right here. Okay, that looks pretty good. Okay, I'll just pull this right over to the side. But I wanna put enough around the edge that the edges are held on pretty good. And I'm just gonna kinda put it all the way around.
Now I'll lay my non-slip mat over that. And push it down. All right, let me push this down. And if you're wondering if I'm getting any super glue on my hands, I'm getting just a little bit. You could certainly wear gloves if you wanted to. I really didn't get that much on my hands though. I'll give this about half an hour to let the super glue fully dry, and then I'll come back and finish it. So the anti-slip mat is now completely glued to the bottom of my wood. And I considered using some of the little rubber feet on here, but let me show you why I went ahead and went with the mat instead of the rubber feet. The top of this mini fridge is really the only place that I have to put my bubble wrap holder. And you can see that, let me try to get out of that glare, it's kind of recessed right here. And I was worried that the feet may not hit all the points on here to keep the whole thing from sliding, because there's only a small lip right back here and on each side. So I wanted to get the maximum amount of no slip surface. So this has had plenty of time to cure and it's stuck on there pretty well. I also wanted to show you this. My ex-wife was at Goodwill the other day and she came across 5 bundles of bubble millers. There's the other one I opened up. And these were only $1.99, and I think there's 25 in here, and they're pretty decent quality. They kind of feel like they're paper, kind of like these, just white. And since I've been slacking on ordering my packing supplies, I've been getting these from Dollar Tree at about 70 cents each. So, but at $1.99, these are super cheap, and I think they are 8.5 by 10 or 8.5 by 11. But I do use a lot of bubble mailers, so I'm glad that she found these and picked them up for me. Now this doesn't have to be exact, but I do want to get it fairly close. So I'm going to mark the center of my wood where I'm going to put the spindle that holds my bubble wrap. Yeah, it's right on. So I'm going to put this right around the middle. And I'm just going to screw it on. Okay, that's on pretty securely. And I'll stick my little middle piece in. And although I don't have too much bubble wrap, that should do it. And this will work whether you have bubble wrap with a core or not. I don't see it being any issues, because this particular thing here, now it actually spins because of this outer piece, because it's kind of an extendable shower curtain rod. But if you have something like, if you're going to use PVC, which I would use PVC if I didn't have this, with just a PVC flange and probably a piece of 1 inch, maybe 1.5 inch pipe, shouldn't be any issue with being able to pull it and have your stand sitting in place. I think just to be sure that I'm getting the maximum amount of non-slippage, if that is a word, I'm going to use some of this extra non-slip mat right here in the middle, since really the only thing that's going to be gripping are these outer edges. This will grip to the top of the mini fridge, and then the other part of the mat will grip to this. Let me sit that on. All right, so it is good and grippy. I can grab my bubble wrap, nothing will move. So I think this little project, I'm gonna be happy with it. I'm not really happy with all my boxes falling over everywhere. I think I mentioned earlier in the video, I am amassing as many of these small boxes as possible, since I'm shipping mostly Ground Advantage right now. But anyway, I think this is gonna work out pretty well. And it lets me utilize wasted space. Although I did have the other boxes that are down here, up here before. But I am betting that a lot of people probably have maybe about 1.5 feet of wasted space that they could use to make something like this. So I think it's going to work out pretty well.
I just wanted to do this little video showing my bubble wrap project because I was thinking maybe it could help someone else if they're looking for a pretty good storage solution for their bubble wrap. And that's going to do it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel. As always, I appreciate you watching, and I'll see you in the next video.